right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to game three of this best two out of three. We've got some rain out here, Fernando.
Oh, yeah, we do. You know, this is it. Do or die.
Now, the Unicorns are the home team for this third game. We now have a different umpire behind the plate. They rotate every game. So now you're going to have a semi-different strike zone, Fernando.
Yeah, you sure do. So now, nonetheless, Bethany Aguilar up first to bat. So now we are the away team.
Exactly. High fly, make that a foul ball.
Foul ball.
You know, the bats are wet, the ball is wet, the gloves are wet.
Well, you know, who's going to have the advantage on this, Henry?
Exactly. So the Unicorns bring out a different pitcher here.
You know, yeah, well, can the pitcher hold on to the ball? Because now it's a little slippery, Henry.
Yep, it's a whole different.
Little low on that one.
One ball, two strikes. For Bethany. We're just trying to stay dry right now. Our biggest issue is we're starting to get hungry, you know. And that's that could prove interesting. Oh, there's a hit, but foul.
Oh, she tagged it good
right,
too, Henry.
That was good. That was
good. Oh, it's over there at the wall.
There you go. Of course, our TV crew now have their rain gear on and the cameras are covered. And Dave's back in the truck manning the whole system. So it's all good. We had our 35-40 minute break here. Rain kind of got in the way, and it is raining right now. So makes for a completely different ball game. That's high.
This is going to come down to the pitcher,
yep.
Henry. That's what it's going to come down to.
2-2.
Can she get it over the plate?
That's key. Can she get it over the plate, Fern? That one's low. So it's a full count now, 3-2. You know, my biggest issue is, you know, now that we're in a third game, I'm gonna be pretty worn out tomorrow. I may have to call Mr. Isasi and say, hey, look, pal, I'm gonna need a little time off here. You know, kind of worn out. I'm not a spring chicken anymore, and so, you know, kind of wears on you. All right, here we go. Full count, 3-2. Top of the first.
Bethany got eyes this one.
Got under it, and that should be an out. Nope, not able to catch it. Stays in there, fighting it off, Fernando.
Got to be a strike. Got to
be a strike. Fighting it off, 2-3.
Yeah, that one came off her shin.
But neither the pitcher nor the batter giving in here.
Not at all. Looks like the rain is almost. We still got a little bit of drizzle.
We'll know as soon as Sergio takes off his old man in the C outfit out there. There's a shot past the third base. And that's a single, Fernando.
Up to bat will be number three, Elisa Rubio.
All righty.
Kind of how we started the game, the last game, getting that first one on base.
Run on first, no out. The next batter, right fielder number three, Elisa Rubio.
Now it goes back to our strategy. Now you want to get advance your runner.
Exactly. Foul ball. Oh, that was close.
Very close.
It's all good. It's all good. But that was the idea. Advance the runner, Fernando. Show and bunt. One ball, one strike. Emily giving instructions to her teammates. That's low. Two balls, one strike. And it also affects the catcher, Fernando, on a low pitch.
Oh, yeah.
That thing can squirt by if you're not careful. And, again, you know, this field is completely, it's all 100% artificial turf. Fights that one off. Two balls, two strikes, no out. Runner on first. So, Fernando, what do you think the key to this ball game is?
Well, you know, I think it comes right there. The pitcher and the catcher. You know, can the catcher hold on to the ball? Can the pitcher put it over the plate? You know, and give himself a chance for some defense or some missed hits or something. You know, I mean, anything can happen out here. You just added water to the whole mix.
Yeah, exactly.
Now we got a full count, 3-2.
3-2.
So just a matter of watching the ball now. What kind of pitch is she going to get?
Fighting it off is what's going on. And by the way, I found my old KSBG cap. Ball going to short. Got an out, but she did her job.
Yeah,
she advanced the runner.
On second, and one out, the next batter. The pitcher number 20, Emily Delgado.
All right, now you got Emily Delgado. Not only can she hit, the girl has speed.
That she does, Henry.
So let's see what Coach Martinez has decided to do here. Ball one. You got a runner on second. You got one out. And just like as the rain goes by, it starts to get humid. Ball two. Now it's humid, Fernando. I'm sorry. I tell you, man, we can't win for losing today. It's all good. There's a strike. Two balls, one strike, one out, one runner on second. Lots of respect because everybody's back to the wall.
Oh, yeah.
There's a hit to short, bobbles the ball, gets an out. But now the runner's to third.
You got to hand it that shortstop. I mean, she does a good job of recovering, Henry.
Yeah, she's an excellent little athlete. Okay, now you got the first baseman up.
Kylie Sanchez.
Shortstop number 9, Kylie Sanchez.
Yeah, Hounds have got to get on the board here early.
Exactly. I think that is key. Ball. Even if it's just one run, psychologically,
exactly.
that does a lot. There's a hit to third base, and that squirts all the way through to the outfield. So that's one run. Oh, you called it, pal. You called it.
That was the idea.
There you go.
I'm surprised Coach hasn't brought in a runner for her.
Now it's starting to rain again. Now you got the big guns up to bat.
Right.
You've got two out.
Yeah, Mira Rodriguez coming up to bat. Buddy taking a walk back to the fence.
Lots of respect. Ball. Let's see. that was kind of a Forrest Gump type of deal where it was raining and all of a sudden just stopped. That's another ball. Two balls,
well,
no
just
strikes.
Held down to that one, Henry.
They got to be real careful where they pitch this young lady because she has power. And foul ball. Two balls, one strike. She was just a little late on that.
Just a little.
Just a little. The Lady Greyhounds with one run up. That one's low. Got a runner on first. Three balls, one strike. Yeah,
that runner on first got the catcher nervous over here.
Concession stand is open for your convenience. Thank you.
That concession stand is about the has the price of about Minute Maid Park.
Oh, yeah.
Holy
smokes.
That
was Peggy. Peggy was telling me, I said, forget that.
Oh, foul tip.
Went for a little low one.
Three balls, two strikes. Two outs, runner on first. Yeah, that's a little pricey out there, but it is what it is, man, you know.
Yeah.
They raise funds for their programs. There's a drive to center field.
Line drive.
Makes it the second. So now you got runners on first and second, and you got the catcher coming up.
That's right, Jojo Montes.
Jojo Montes does not mess around.
Coach is going to go check on Kylie over there.
Yeah, he.
I would have brought in a runner back at first, you know, but I don't get to make that call. Or Kylie doesn't want to come out.
No, she doesn't want to come out.
There's no way.
She's like,
there you go.
Nope, not happening, Coach.
Keep the girls happy.
That's it. I was talking to Coach Partida Ram a little while ago and tell him how the concession stand over at the old high school, we used to go to a little window to go pick up our food. We paid for our food.
Yeah.
That's when I first had my first Frito chili pie.
There you go.
Oh, my gosh. Times were different. Ball. Now it's hot Cheeto pie. I don't know. I'm not into that.
I don't know. Once in a while, I'm daring and get something.
Oh, you know you're bringing the big dogs out when you get some Fritos and bean dip.
Oh yeah, that I still
There's
do.
A hit to third base. That's an automatic out. So, bats are hot right now.
Well, they are. They are. So you know, Lady Hounds top of the first inning here, one run in. That sets a tone, Henry.
And that sets a tone.
Gets back to the pitching. All right, we saw Emily Delgado earlier. Came in and did a heck of a job finishing the game.
Well, plus it's not raining any longer. That's a big advantage right now.
It sure is.
Coach Martinez talking to his troops, trying to encourage them. Keep everything positive. Right now, Fernando, I'm thinking about where am I going to stop to eat on the way home?
I have no idea.
You know.
I know Peggy was like, okay, where? I don't know.
Well, you see, my thing is my cardiologist says I'm not supposed to have Whataburger.
There you go.
And that's a tough thing. Now, I can go to Whataburger if I have a salad. But I have a salad for lunch every day, Monday through Friday. So this is the weekend, man. I want to have some chicharrones or something, man. Or some good old, you know what, man? Good old-fashioned tacos, man. But, oh, well, life is hard. What do you do? That's why I had my full serving of veggies at lunchtime. I didn't want to stray too far away from my salad, you know. I wasn't supposed to eat the skin on the chicken, but, oh, well. I broke down and had it.
That's the best part.
It is to me. There's a company out of California that sells that stuff, believe it or not.
Really?
Yes. Sells it to you just like a chip.
Yeah, like a chicharrones.
Same thing.
Chicken chicharrones.
But I don't know. I don't remember the name of it. I'll have to look it up. Let's see, Fernando. This is big here. This is gonna tell us a lot, I think, this first inning.
I think so, Henry.
Lady Unicorn, the DP, number two, Mac Gaspar.
Strike one.
The strike right away, Henry.
Didn't mess around. Well, Serge took his hat off, so he's okay back there. Still has his raincoat on. Little outside, 1-1.
Little high, I guess.
Little high. Two balls, one strike. Quick shout out to my good buddy, pharmacist Paul Resendez and pharmacist Amadeo Valenzuela.
There you go.
Who are at home watching the ball game. We hope you guys are enjoying today's softball game. It's all good. Ball two, strike one. And that's foul. So 2-2 goes to the count. Again, lots of experience on Emily's behalf.
It's your reminder, you return those foul balls to the nearest dugout.
That's low.
Little bit low. 3-2 in the count.
3-2. Albert Mosqueda says I should get a chef salad in Kingsville at the steakhouse.
There you go.
Dude, if I'm going to steakhouse, I'm having a steak.
I was
going
to say, you get
I'm
the salad,
sorry.
I'm winning steak also.
It's all good.
Not a bad idea, Albert.
There's a hitch, the short, Amira with the play.
Make it look easy, Henry.
Make it look easy. Just routine, pal. One out. Still in the first inning, bottom of the first. The Lady Greyhounds ahead, 1-0.
That's what you want to look for. You know, if they get some hits, keep them in the infield and make your basic plays. Make them look routine.
And that is that a ball?
I believe so. It was low.
Okay. Well, Balde at home back in San Manito, he says he's watching the game on his computer. And he heard me talk about chicken skins. He says we need to try the chicharrones at Classics in Harlingen.
Classics. There you go.
Oh, that's a nice little blooper. That falls in for a single.
Yeah, she just kind of put that ball out there. Just to get it over the infield. That's it.
It's all good.
And right over first base. I mean, it's wide open here.
We're on first.
They're called Chicarrones. Chicarrones at Classics in Harlingen. Dude, I don't even know where Classics is. It's somewhere in Harlingen. I mean, we can just Google it up.
I'm sure we'll figure it out.
That's not an issue, you know, especially now in today's world. We can't live without our phones. Strike one. One out. Runner on first. We could see a double play here, Fernando. Let's see. Strike it.
Strike
two. Emily bringing the heat. Ball. One ball, two strikes. Hey, Got one out here at the bottom of the first inning. That's a nice pitch, bringing the still 1-2.
If you turn those foul balls to the nearest dugout.
Oh, there you go. That was nice.
You know, it looked like it was coming in with some heat, and it just slowed down.
Okay, Imelda Piñon Hernandez wants to send a message to Dave back in the truck. One of the cameras has raindrops on it. So there you go. Thank you, Imelda.
Oh, I wonder which one it is.
I don't know. I'm sure they're all you know, Dave back there in the truck, man, he can see everything.
And it could be our
little rover here.
Our little rover unmanned was. That's the one that didn't have a cover on it.
Good question.
Another strike.
All righty. Foul ball, strike two, just like that. Out in front of the batter, two strikes, no balls. Now I'm thinking about that steakhouse, man. I don't know, I'm sorry, man, but I go to a steakhouse, man. I'm not, I'm not having a salad now, sorry. Okay, so Balde, okay, hold on. We're going to wait for Emily to pitch this one. Oh, nice pitch. Balde says that place Classics is located over there next to Elliott's, right by Hook, Line, and Sinker. Classics.
So I have to look for it.
Have to look for it. No worries. It's all good. Thank you, Balde. Oh, they sent Sam over here to check it out. Yeah, I don't know. That ball no bueno. Oh, got a little wet here. And it finally stopped raining.
Yeah, it did.
Completely, I think.
And the wind?
Yeah, there's no wind now. What wind?
Went away. Get that little breeze going to be nice and fresh.
Safe. Safe at second.
Not by much.
Yeah, Amira was not quite able to handle that ball. That ball just popped out of her glove. It got thrown, but it hit the bottom of her glove and squeezed out when she squeezed her hand. So ball one. Ball one, strike two.
Well, we're going to walk her with two strikes.
Dang.
I don't know. Going to walk her with two strikes. Interesting call.
It's all good. Oh, so Ernie's inviting us over to his house, Ernie Leal. He's got New York strips. What the heck, Ernie?
Yeah.
That's just wrong, pal.
No kidding.
I'll be there in 2.5 hours.
They're good. They look good.
They look good. You got to remember, man. Hey, you got to remember, Ernie knows what he's doing. It's all good. The guy's great at stuff like that. Now you got runners at first and second. There's a strike. That was an interesting call, Fernando.
Well, you know, you got to look at what your defense can bring right now. And you can get an out.
You got two
anywhere.
Outs.
You got two outs, but you can throw the ball at any base.
At any base and get an out.
Yeah. A lot of strategy here.
Yeah, absolutely. And that is a call or a foul. So now,
hello. They got two on it.
I think they got two strikes. No, two strikes ahead of the count here. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Runners on first and second. I think the scoreboard kind of fell asleep up there.
I think so.
It's all good. We all do once in a while, so no worries. Yeah.
Strike number three.
Oh, snap a lack. So that paid dividends, Fernando. That walk.
Oh, sure did.
You know, take their no biggest weapon and don't allow
take her.
Take her out of play.
That's it. That is it.
See? Coach Martinez, man, talking about the mental strategy. Right, look at him.
There you go.
Pointing to the temples. That's right. It's all about staying in this ball game mentally.
Yeah. There you go. There you go. Blanca Montemayor just recommended Nico's Steakhouse.
Again.
Right here on Saratoga. We're close by, Henry. I'll tell you what. We'll let Peggy take over. You and I go have a steak.
That may not be a bad idea.
Or Robert Rodriguez. He came by. He can come and talk some softball.
Which, by the way,
Robert.
I'm sorry,
there
but
you go.
Amira is not Robert's granddaughter. Sorry about that, guys.
It's actually Elisa Rubio.
Elisa Rubio. Is that her granddaughter? His granddaughter.
Well.
Okay. So, Valde says hello. Back in San Benito. He's on his computer watching us.
There you go.
So he said to tell you hello.
All right.
It's all good, man.
Good to see you guys. Or hear from you guys. Blanca, glad you could join us.
There you go, Blanca.
I got good. Peggy sitting on your cover over here. Can't get wet. It's all good. All right, number 23, Mia Gonzalez up to bat for the Lady Hounds. So now, Coach Martinez's strategy, get another one.
That's it. I mean, you take one run at a time.
There you go.
Strike one. That was a good pitch.
I don't think the scoreboard's functioning anymore, Henry.
It may not be. Maybe it got wet. It's got a short. And they got to send a technician.
Well, I'll tell you what. You can just send Serge over there.
That's ball.
Not only will he fix it, those lights will be purple.
There you go. Quick.
There you go.
There you go. Two
came
balls, no strikes.
Came back alive.
They heard you, Fern.
I think he went.
They heard you.
He didn't want to change it to purple, huh? All right. Two balls, no strikes.
There's a ball, and that one goes foul.
Not by much either, Henry.
Not by much. Whew. I tell you what.
He would have been rounding second.
So here's the other thing. Once Mia finishes batting, and right now the count is 1-2, we're going back to the top of the order. Or not. No.
Not yet.
No, we got Jenna. My bad. My eyes do not work as well as they used to. One ball. Actually, it's actually my brain, I think.
But I'll tell you what, Henry, you know, anywhere in this lineup, you're going to get some kids that are going to be on base. There you go. Again, right
Wow.
over first base.
She's got her number. She just has to get a little quicker.
Tell you what, if she doesn't go there and goes in between first and the second baseman, and you can see the second baseman is playing way over.
There's a huge gap there.
Huge gap.
The
right
only
over.
Defender you have right there is an umpire.
Yeah.
That's high.
Very high.
Two balls, two strikes. So it causes you to pitch away from your batter, Fernando.
Yeah, it does.
That
another
one.
Another high ball.
Another high ball. Full count now.
3-2.
No outs.
They're going to make this young lady pitch.
Oh, foul tip. That tells you how wet it is. Mia slipped there. Big shout out to J-Rod, the man himself.
There you go.
Says, go Lady Hounds. That's right.
Good old J-Rod.
Good old J-Rod. Oh, good pitch. So there's your first out, but not after a whole bunch of pitches.
A ton of pitches.
Well, big shout out to my man, Rudy Ramirez from Brownsville.
There you go.
He says he's now craving a steak. Well, there you go, pal. Go get
tell
one.
Tell him to go get her Ernie's over there.
Yeah, run over to Ernie's. Make that 15-minute trip over to Ernie's. Ernie, I think Rudy Ramirez wants one of your ribeye steaks.
There you
pal.
Go. Jenna Torres up to bat.
Strike one. Ball, one and one. One ball, one strike, one out. Top of the second. Lady Greyhounds ahead, 1-0. You got to remember, it only takes one to win the ball
game. There you
go. That's low.
Low.
Two balls, one strike.
Jenna trying to make something happen here.
Strike two, 2-2, one out. Big pitch here, Fernando. That's low. Full count now. Three balls, two strikes, one out. There's a hit, goes right to second base, and a nice out. So that's a routine play there.
Well, that brings us to the back of the top of the batting order with Bethany Aguilar up to bat.
You know what, next year I'm gonna buy a pitch counter, Fernando.
There you go. I'm sorry, Leila Lopez.
I'm gonna buy a pitch counter.
There you go.
Of course,
we're gonna need one.
Well, of course, it's very simple. We can do the stick figures.
Oh yeah, we could.
You know, we could, but nah. Let's look fancy. Oh, that's high. Yeah, we'll just keep it real, folks. One ball, no strikes, two outs.
All
now
right,
that scoreboard is working.
Yeah.
Strike one. One ball, one strike, two outs. Still no win. Fortunately, it's not steaming right now. Little floater. Oh, that's going to be a base hit as the third baseman was not able to handle that
there
ball.
There you go.
It hit the tip of her glove.
So now we come to the top of the batting order.
Now we come to the top of the batting order. And once again, the Greyhounds are notorious for making things happen with two outs.
On first. And two outs. The next batter. Top of the order. Second baseman number five, Bethany Aguilar.
That's low. Runner advances. Safe.
That's a key right there.
That is the
right
key
there.
Is right. So now you got a runner on second. Hey, big gap between center field and right field for Nando.
Oh, yeah.
A huge gap. There's a hit going to center field, and that's an out. So the Lady Hounds strand one on base, but that's the end of the top of the second inning. We're now going to go to the bottom of the second inning. So no runs by the Lady Hounds in this inning.
No, one runner left on base.
So let's see. Hey, guys. It's all good. Serge over there, he's over in center field.
He's at center field.
You're earning your money, pal.
There you go.
Earning that money. It's all good.
I think they're playing the right tune for him right
that
now.
That is true. That is very true.
That old Serge can play center field.
Yeah. Put me in, coach.
Yeah, hey, put me in, coach. Look at me. I can play center
field. I don't know, man. The only thing I'm thinking about is where am I going to get my steak? Am I going to get it here in Corpus? Am I going to get it in Kingsville? Or is Ernie going to save us some steaks San Benito?
Yeah. You never know.
You never know.
You got
right.
choices. How about all of the above?
I can't eat that much anymore.
We can't do that no more, right?
Joe Avila. Okay, where's he at? Let me see. I know Joe's probably not even in town. Oh, he's got the pit going over in San Benito. So there you go. He's got everything ready. Got the pit fired up and he's ready to cook. What's he cooking? Oh, he's got some sausage there. Some fajitas. He's ready to go. Nomás faltan las tortillas. I'm sure he has them somewhere. There you go, Joe.
I think it's the camera over at third base at the water droplets.
There you go. Foul ball. That's caught by a fan. There you go. Go get your raspa, pal. There you go.
We're gonna have to ask Ernie where he got those steaks.
I'm telling you, man. They better be prime, boy. Because, you know, I'm old, man. My dientes, man, they're not as strong as they used to be. So, you know what?
Well, you got to bring your second pair, Henry.
I'm getting there. All right, no balls. One strike. Score remains 1-0 in favor of the Lady Greyhounds. That's outside. One ball, one strike now. Oh, big cut.
Ring right there.
But that big cut was way late.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, that ball was almost in the catcher's mitt by the time she went through.
Shout out to Linda Vela watching the game. I'll tell you what, we had a great time last night. I say we. She was there for her grandkids.
Okay.
You know, huge FFA kids. I'll tell you what, just doing great. Kylie, the oldest, is on her way out being a senior. But I'll tell you what, we're going to miss her.
All right, two balls, two strikes.
But she's got a little brother named Sean coming up the ranks there. These are Rudy Garza's kids.
Oh, yeah, Sean, absolutely, man. He's one of my golfers.
Great kids.
At least I'm hoping he's one of my golfers for next year. He was playing some pretty good golf this year as an eighth grader. So
there you go.
It's all good. Two balls, two strikes now.
Well, we're glad you're watching, Linda.
Oh, there's a big hit to left field, and that falls in. That's going to be a stand-up double. So there you go. No outs. Bottom of the second.
Well,
you got a runner on second.
Yeah, but the weather has changed a little bit in the sense that there's no, you know, it's wet on the ground, but the balls are now dry. Bats are dry. Got us a ball game.
Left fielder number 3, Michaela.
So they're going to change out here. They're going to bring in a pinch runner. No outs.
No. Yeah.
Yeah, they switched out the catcher.
First runner at second base, number 24, Michaela Uada.
Now you got a left-handed batter. Strike one. You heard that one pop. That was something else. No balls, one strike, no outs. Runner on second. Ball, 1-1.
Interesting call.
Well, you know, I mean, again, man, that's what these guys get paid to do, so it's all good.
I know the board is showing two strikes, but I don't think that was it. That was correct.
No, it's 1-1.
It's 1-1.
That's a ball. That's two balls, one strike. There's a nice lay there. All right. The Unicorns doing their job, advancing the runner.
There you go.
So now you got one out. Again, I think their scoreboard, you know, has a little short over there.
Runner on third and one out. The next batter, left fielder number one, Malena Candelaria.
I mean, this could come down to be a one-run game for another.
It only takes one.
It only takes one is right. That's a strike.
What a beautiful strike.
I'm telling you, man, she's popping them in there as the baby unicorns are sitting in the stands over there. Strike
another
two.
One.
No balls, two strikes, one out. Homing them in there. Pitcher now ahead of the batter. Foul ball. As the batter has no choice but to fight off the pitches. You know, you're down, the pitcher has the advantage right now. So that's a difficult thing. You got a runner on third base, you've got one out, and you still have two strikes. There are no balls. Emily Delgado showing her leadership once again, Fernando. Done a hell of a job all year long.
Oh, yeah.
Big.
Almost got her a third.
Almost got a double. So there you go. Two outs now. Okay, this will be a slap. This is the smallest player on that unicorn team. She's going to slap the ball. And the idea is just get one, you know, get her out at first and you're done. Ball one. Good to see that the fans are out in force still.
Oh, they're still here, Henry. They're not going anywhere.
Yep, absolutely. Nice. 1-1. There's a little slap. Oh,
almost.
Jenna, almost. A diving effort there. So two strikes. Two strikes, two outs. One ball. J- Jenna was one of my students last year, another great kid. Smart and very kind. All right, one ball, two strikes, two outs. Bottom of the second.
Right.
Outside.
Oh. Boy, that looked good.
Two and two. Two, two and two. Catcher did not even move her glove.
No, she didn't.
And fighting it off. Two strikes, two balls. Two outs. Lady Greyhound, bottom of the second. We hope you guys are at home enjoying your barbecue. Or maybe some popcorn.
Well, hopefully the weather's a little nicer over there.
Yeah, I would think so. Yeah, it's all good. You know. Getting some dry softballs into the ball game. All right, two and two, two outs. Runner on third. Emily Delgado, the pitcher. That's low. Full count.
Low.
So you're trying to get her to go after it.
Yeah.
All right, three balls, two strikes, two outs. Runner on third. Lady Greyhounds ahead, 1-0. Foul ball. Fighting it off. I mean, we know she's going to squib it.
Yeah, everybody's playing up a little bit.
She's trying to squib it toward third base. Playing way back in the batter's box. Got her looking.
Beautiful.
So just like that, three
that's
outs.
That's experience right there, Henry.
That's experience right there is correct, Fernando.
Wow.
So that ends the second inning. We now go to the top of the third.
Lady Hounds up 1-0.
Coach Martinez talking to his troops out there right now. He wants to make sure everybody stays positive. Everybody understands what's going on. All right, we're getting a shot of the unicorns up there. We actually have three. We've got an adult unicorn out there somewhere. So it's all good. All right, Albert Sanchez. Go Lady Hounds. He's over at Ben Zapata's house.
There you go.
I hope you guys are having a good barbecue there, Albert. Be sure and give my best to Ben. Another, you know, some great players, man.
Oh,
those
yeah.
guys are great Greyhounds.
Both of those guys.
Joe says that it's muggy with gnats in San Benito. Well, you know what? I'm going to say, well, you know what? I should. It's very simple. In our with our technology today, it's 81 degrees
there
here.
There you go.
With about a 5-mile-an-hour wind, you know. So it's all good. Let's see. Spark Lightning says that. Okay, it's moving away. 20.2 miles.
Oh, yeah.
So earlier we were at 16 miles as far as how close the lightning was. So that's all good. All right, big bats coming up, Fernando.
Well, just going to start off with Elisa Rubio.
Well, Elisa, no slouch at the batter's box.
Well, no, you know, and if he gets on base, you know, you've got some, well, at least four strong batters coming up after
and you,
that.
And you got some speed here in this young lady.
Yeah, that you do.
That ball is outside, ball one. Top of the third. Ball two, course, we could go back to Baffin Bay and have some seafood. You know, I mean, that's always, you just can't go wrong with that one either. Jeepers. Decisions, decisions, decisions. Strike one. One ball, one strike. Two balls, one strike. There's a little flapper. Third baseman gets it. A little low. Oh. That was close.
Whoa.
All right, one out.
One out with Emily Delgado coming up
to bat. So you don't really want to walk anyone here.
No, you don't.
Because, you're going to end up loading the bases.
Now nobody on that side of the pitcher, number 20.
All right, one out.
Well, now the weather's prime for some big hits.
Strike one. There's a hit to short. And that's an easy out.
Tell you what, shortstop does her job. She does a good job.
She's a great little athlete.
Was that, Emily hit that.
Oh, she hit it well.
Pretty hard. So up next, Kylie Sanchez to bat.
We got two outs now here at the top of the third.
With two outs, nobody on. The next batter, first baseman number 9,
Kylie Sanchez. There's a hit to first, and that's three outs. Yeah. That ends the top of the third very quickly. One,
very
two, and three,
quick.
Fernando.
That was a very quick inning.
Well, now can the Lady Greyhounds do the same thing?
Well, that's the objective right now.
Yep. Again, you only need one run to win the ballgame. You know?
Lady Greyhounds. Top half of third inning. No runs, no hits, no errors, no runners left on base. 2-2 and a half. San Benito 1. New Paltz 0.
Again, we certainly hope you guys are enjoying the ball game at home. Inside, where it's nice and cool. It's all good. Oh, by the way, we'll be having our annual golf camp through the after-school program. So thank you, Albert Sanchez. So that's gonna be starting here soon.
Oh, that'll be cool. Is that open to anybody or what? What's the requirement?
I'm not sure yet.
That?
They have not put up the details, but it's all good. My son is the one that runs it, you know, and he's more than knowledgeable. So. It's all good. Looks like there's going to be another substitution here.
Yeah, I hadn't seen this lady come off the bat.
You know, what I'm noticing is these sleeves on these girls. I guess it must be a common thing in New Braunfels. There's a strike.
It's got to be about 6'2".
Yeah. You know what they say, the bigger they are, the harder they fall. But let's see what this young lady can bring. Strike two. She was way behind on that pitch.
Yeah, way behind and went after one, a low pitch, which, I mean, but it was in there, though.
So, ball one. One ball, two strikes.
Whoa.
Steve Iyer wants to score Well, right now, Steve, it's the Chaminito Lady Greyhounds 1 and New Braunfels 0, and we're at the bottom of the third inning, pal. Okay, I hope that helps out. That's little a little high.
Little high on that one.
2-2. Oh, that's a nice pitch. Outside, full count.
Didn't get it, though.
Big shout out to Norman Gaither, all the way from Tryon, Georgia. San Benito High School class of 1980. Go Lady Hounds. That's right, Norman. It's all good. Hope everything is well in Tryon, Georgia. Former Greyhound.
Always a Greyhound.
That's right. Oh, that was a walk. All right. You got a runner on first. You got no outs.
It's on with the walk. First, no outs. The next batter is right fielder number 11, Lily Warren.
Play in two is what Coach Martinez. There's a slap. Oh, they go over a mirror at one. Well, they got the lead runner out.
Yeah.
So they did their job.
Well, yeah, they did. It just squirted out of her glove. That's all it was.
Again, it hit her. It hit the bottom part of the glove, and when she squeezed it, it went out. So you got one out now. You got a runner on first.
On the fielder's choice. Runner on first. One out. The next batter. Center fielder number 6, Veronica Pyderson.
That ball's a little high. Ball one. Outside, two balls, no strikes, one out. And of course, let's not forget, the field is probably still a little wet.
Oh, it sure is.
Without a doubt, especially with no wind, you know, nothing to really dry it out. Runner going, but that's a foul. So two balls, one strike. Sounds like the fans are getting a little fired up over there, Fernando. That's outside. Three balls, one strike, one out. Runner on first. Jenna's gonna go over and talk to Emily real quick. Play in two, that's the goal. Give the batter something to bite at, and let's see if the defense can handle it. There you go, full count. Three balls, two strikes. Now the batter has no choice but to try and fight Emily off. Now, Emily's defense has played great all year long. And that's what she relies on. She's going to pitch what Coach Martinez tells her that she's supposed to pitch.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, foul tip. Like I said, she's going to try and fight it off here. The last thing she wants to do is get caught off guard and just watch the pitch go by. All right, three balls, two strikes, one out. Runner on first here. Emily Delgado, your pitcher. High fly ball, Emily calls for it. And both girls.
Out number two, Henry.
That's right.
Runner stays on first.
Now that's a dangerous play because these girls need to be able to hear each other. Otherwise, you know, they're going to run into each other and then you make a mistake. That's right. They're not going to bat to her. They're not going to give her the opportunity she wants with a big bat. So now you have a runner on first and second. You got two outs.
Who's on an intentional walk? Now batting, first baseman number 19, Grace Simons.
So this young lady, Grace Simons, all the pressure's on her right now because she's at bat and she's got to get a hit.
Oh, sure.
We got to get a stop. There's a big hit. Who's got it? It's going to fall in. That's an out. Wow.
That's huge defense right there.
That's huge defense right there. And guess what? You took their number one batter and took her out.
That's it.
For at least an inning and a half. Maybe. We don't know.
You know
now,
and that's just coaching, Henry.
That's it. Now we're going to the top of the fourth. No errors, two runners left on. And again, all we need is one run.
I'm sure Coach Martinez wants to have a little more cushion than that.
I'm sure. But yeah, at the end of the day.
True. You know, it, last game, I mean, both teams were getting on base and leaving players on base. But now, you know, it's going to come down to defense.
Actually, it's my hips. My hips and my knees.
All right, leading off for the Lady Hounds, number 14, Amira Rodriguez.
The research that I've done on the medications that I'm taking, yeah, this is a side effect of some of that. So what do you do? I'm good.
Now we got all sorts of unicorns, Henry.
What's that?
I think that adult unicorn
yeah, I
came
told
over.
You that they had a big unicorn.
There you go.
San Benito side trying to create their own wave of some sort.
Oh, yeah.
So it's all good.
They're keeping busy having fun.
Yeah, that's right. They're not thinking about steak right now. So it's all good. Well, Amira Rodriguez, the batter, first batter up, strike one. So I set myself up here, and I'm hoping I don't get wet from the residual water that's up on top of this tent.
Hopefully not.
I could be setting myself up for failure. There's a hit down the third base side, and that's foul. So quickly the pitcher gets out in front of the batter, 0-2. Two strikes, no out, top of the fourth inning.
Another
ball two, 2-2. That's high. Ball three, full count, no outs. First batter, Amira being very patient.
Got a seagull out there.
I guess he must have heard about my steak is what happened. He's looking for it.
See if he dropped anything.
It's all good. There's a hit to third base. Between a gap, gets a single. So is this where it starts, Fernando?
Well, it could, Henry. You know, like I said, it's middle of this lineup. It just loaded.
Dude, you got JoJo Montes up to bat right
yeah.
now. You got no outs, and you got a runner on first. There's a hit, third base. Wow, that was close, but it's all good. One out, they got the lead runner out, and you got JoJo Montes on first, and there's gonna be a pinch runner for her. So you've got one out. You got Mia Gonzalez up the bat, I believe.
Yep, it's Mia Gonzalez.
You got a speedster on first base.
Yeah, now you got your speed. Your speed group here, Henry.
What's that, Fernando?
You got your speed group coming up here.
Yes.
Mia Gonzalez. One.
Now, New Braunfels already has one error in this ballgame. The Lady Hounds have zero.
Lady Hounds
have four hits, while New Braunfels has two hits.
One ball, no strikes.
Foul ball.
Foul.
1-1 is the count. Top of the fourth. Score remains 1-0 in favor of the Lady Ground.
A little high. Runner's going to go to second.
Going to second. Safe.
Bobbles the ball. So now the runner at second.
One out. All right, we got Ariel Cruz. Go Lady Greyhounds. That's right, Ariel. Go Lady Greyhounds. You got one out right now. Two balls, one strike. Ball outside.
Three balls, one strike.
There you go. Ya no miro, Fern. I guess I'm dyslexic. I don't know, man. Or either that, or I'm just thinking too much about my steak. With a Diet Coke. Baba. Full count, Fern. Full count.
A steak and a Diet Coke.
Steak and a Diet Coke. And give me some veggies on the side, because I can't have no French fries.
Well, they're potatoes and veggies.
Not technically. It's got too many carbs, pal. Unless it's a sweet potato.
There you go.
If you get a sweet potato, you're probably okay. Hey, my phone is ringing. What
three
the
and
heck?
Two. 3-2.
That's low.
No, that one's just going to walk it.
So now you got runners on first and second.
Who is Jenna Torres coming up to bat, number 7.
So Jenna's our third baseman.
One out, runners on first and second.
That's outside, ball. All right, Jenna, make this happen, kid. Huge gap between center field and left field, Fernando. Huge. Again, these two teams have scouted each other very well. Lays down a bunt. That's good. They get one out, but runners advance.
But the runners advance. And that's that's crucial, Henry.
That was the idea.
Yeah, now we got Layla Lopez coming up to bat.
Sacrifice for Torres. Who's on second and third?
All right, you got two outs. Top of the fourth, Fernando.
Well, got to make your pitch first. Get a couple of pitches in there first.
Let's see. That's outside. I called it from here. All right, ball one. Make your pitch, right? That's right, Fernando. Make your pitch. Strike one, 1-1. Foul ball, 1-2. Pitch right in front of the batter. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Runners on second and third. Top of the fourth. I mean, you could literally bloop it right over the second baseman and have a huge hit.
Oh, yeah.
Two and two.
Close call. That was close.
Foul tip.
Yeah, she would have gotten a walk, not a walk, you'd been a ball three on that one. That was low.
That was low. But as a batter, hey, you got the perfect vision, man. Trying to fight it off. Anything over third base would also big time revenue.
Oh, yeah.
There's a hit straight to third, and that's going to be foul. Tying her shoes, Layla.
Oh, we got two balls, two strikes. It says two outs.
Okay, here we go. 2-2-2, pal. Oh, that's inside. Ball three. I tell you what, we've got Mr. Enrique Martinez from Dallas, proud 77 graduate of San Benito High School, brother of Coach Elias Martinez.
There you go.
Saying purple and gold shall always be. Go Lady Hounds.
That's awesome,
Enrique. That's awesome. Here's a hit. Should be an easy play. And there you go. Getting the third out. All right, so that is the end, or that brings us to the middle of the fourth inning. Remember, we only play seven innings.
It was no runs on one hit.
So let's see.
No errors. Two runs.
Let's see what the Lady Hounds are able to do here defensively. So far, they've held it off. Coach Martinez trying to keep his troops calm, Fernando. That's the idea.
Well, it's a tight ball game, Henry.
You know, it is.
And now it's just going to come down to, is anybody going to make that mistake? Now, now I'm sitting down.
There you go.
Trying to make those old sounds. The Unicorns made that one error there, but the Hounds were able to get that run right early in the first inning.
And that's why we said that it would be crucial for the Greyhounds to score in that first inning, even if it was just one run.
Exactly.
Now, right now, the Lady Hounds, left two runners on base, But, you know, hey, it's all good. And again, you really can't question Coach Martinez. Why? The guy's getting inducted into the Rio Grande Valley Coaches Hall of Fame. I mean, that says a lot. Plus, all you got to do is look at his record.
There you go.
Oh, my gosh. So, yeah, pretty significant, pal. Pretty significant. There's a pitch outside. And to say that he was our middle linebacker his senior year, or our senior year, 1979. I remember.
That's putting it mildly here, because he was an animal, you know.
That guy was
that
a
guy
beast.
That guy could play.
Let me put it to you this way. He was not nice.
No. Okay. And he was feared, Henry.
Yes.
You know he was feared across the valley.
His last game, and I'll talk about it here right now. His last game as a senior in 79. We're playing at home, and he got ejected out of the game.
Yeah.
You know? So that's the type of player he was. He was all out, man. He was not leaving anything in the tank, period. Ball two. There's a swing. Second baseman should get it. There you go. That's one out. And that's because Elias followed our other friend, Joe Infante, who was huge. He played middle linebacker. Joe was probably 6'3", 6'4".
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. It's all good. All right, bottom of the fourth, folks. Bottom of the fourth. Again, we certainly hope you guys are at home enjoying this ballgame. Fernando and I certainly are. Our only issue is we're hungry. But I guess that's a daily issue, right?
Yeah.
Ball one. It's all good. Oh, no wonder Steve wanted the update. He's out fishing in the bay.
There you go.
Oh, that brings me to another story. Oh, that was an off speed. Two balls, one strike, one out. I'm sorry, two balls, no strikes, one out. Strike one.
Got her.
Two balls, one strike.
Two balls, one strike.
No runners on base, which is a good thing.
That's a key.
That is the key.
Little foul tip.
Just that quick, Fernando. It's now 2-2. That's right, Enrique, your brother does bleed purple and gold.
Oh, no kidding.
No doubt, as any Greyhound should. That's right, folks. Once a Greyhound, always a Greyhound. A little high there. Full count. You got one out. Bottom of the fourth. Ball. All right, now the Unicorns with a runner on base with one out.
Sonata with the walk. On first, one out. The next batter, that's good, number one, Malena Candelaria.
Okay, so our man Jaime, he wants an update.
Little bunt. Goes out to first, takes it out.
It's one out.
Runner advances to second. That's what they wanted to do right now.
Runner on second, two out. Next batter, second base number 12, Serena Natal.
There's a ball.
Emily Delgado getting the call here in this third game. Winner take all.
That's right. Winner take all.
JoJo Montes still at catching. Little low on that one as well. Two balls, no strike.
Okay, here we go.
They got one ball, one zone strike.
Oh, nice pitch. One and one. You got two outs. Two outs on the unicorn. There's a little slap. Safe. All right, you got runners on first and second, and you've got two outs. That was a great little slap, Fernando.
And it was one of those, it's a tough decision because ultimately it should have gone to first.
Yeah.
But they wanted to keep the runner from advancing.
All right, now you're back to the top of your, where we have that really tall batter. Emily was able to handle her earlier. So let's see what Emily can do here. Right now, Emily just has to focus on one pitch at a time.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
There's strike one. Ball one. All right, so big shout out to Delia and Gilbert from San Benito, from Ernest Leal. There you go. Ernest and Delia, thank you for, Delia and Gilbert, thank you for watching KSBG, keeping your Greyhounds alive here. Oh, strike two. One ball, two strikes. Coach Martinez shouting orders out there.
Constantly coaching Henry.
One ball, two strikes, two outs. Oh, got her! Strike!
Hey, what? Emily's pumped out there, Henry.
So that ends the fourth inning with the Lady Greyhounds still in the lead.
That is huge.
1-0.
That's a difference that you bring when you have an experienced, a senior pitcher that's been in the program for years, Henry. That's a leadership and experience that comes
in. That she brings. Absolutely.
I'll tell you what, I could just imagine, hope we got, we're around when we see Amelia Rodriguez come up as a senior.
Yep, absolutely. Ooh. That'd be awesome.
That's going to be dangerous. We'll see if we can keep Coach Martinez here around that long, too.
Well, you know, I don't know. Tough. I think he's pretty close to retirement.
Yeah.
I know that he started teaching way before I ever did. You know, I took the long way around through college, you know, took the six-year plan. He took the three-year plan. I took the six-and-a-half-year plan. And so that makes a big difference. You know, plus I stopped teaching and went to work for my dad and all that other good stuff. So it's all good. And you got the unicorns going crazy over there. San Benito crowd trying to get into it. quick little story on fishing. Fernando and I used to fish a lot with our buddy Johnny Saucy. One time we went out to the bay, and about marker 19 through 21 somewhere, we had been hunting fish all morning. Finally found a school of redfish on the west side of the intercoastal. And John anchors the boat and says, I'm going to go out there and get him. He gets off the boat, walks over there, no problem. Of course, John at this time probably weighs 140 pounds, okay? What does Henry Valle and Fernando do? I'll tell you here in a little bit.
All right, Bethany Aguilar, top of the batting order, Henry. Let's see if they can make something happen here.
Little ball one.
Yeah, John couldn't weigh about 140 pounds. He just jumped off the boat and went off.
No worries, man. But hold on. We're going to wait until the end of this inning, or the middle is.
Oh, got him in a strike.
Did he call the strike on that
one? Yeah, he did.
Wow. Okay. What do you do? Is that one and one?
It should be
one and one. Should be one and one. That's ball two.
Two and one now.
2-1. That's another ball. So that's 3-1 now. Scoreboard has it wrong, but that's all good.
It's 3-1.
3-1. They needed their Diet Coke, that's why.
Well, Bethany has one to give.
That's a walk.
Just like that, Bethany gets on base. Up to bat number three, Elisa Rubio.
Aguilar on with the walk. On first, no outs. The next batter, right fielder number three, Elisa Rubio.
So Elisa. No, and she knows what to do. She's got one of those role players, Henry.
Exactly.
And does a great job. Of,
and
you know,
she's done a great job
you
all
know,
year
it,
long.
It's great when you have a team and players.
Strike one.
The players understand their role.
Exactly.
You know, I know when I was coaching my basketball team, I had several role players, you know. My point guard, he knew his role was get the ball across half court and get it into play.
Let's
he was
go.
Not the scoring guy.
Foul ball.
Now, if he happened to get, you know, 8-10 points, now that's a bonus.
Yeah.
You know, but, and there were some guys that I would put in, and it's their job is to get four fouls when they went in there and just harass other kids. So I had some great, great role players. They understood it, and they did their job well.
You and know? That's why you were successful
and
at what
had,
you did, Fernando.
You know what? We had some great, you know, and the kids knew. Now my job is to do this.
There's a slap to third. They're going to take the lead runner out.
No, it bounced. That ball bounced. I don't know.
What do you do? All right, you got one out. You got a runner at first.
I don't think he was in position to make that call.
Yeah, I
Henry.
Think that, and that was the issue. But what do you do? All right, top of the fifth.
Emily Delgado.
Emily's up to bat now. Strike one. There's a hit.
There it is. That's what you needed. She holds that second. Now runners at first and second. Nice little tag right there. And that's what you got to do. Little line drive like that, Henry, right over the infield. Get you on base every time.
Had it gone over between any of the fielders, and that would have been, that probably could have been a home run. But it's all good. You got one out.
Kylie
got a runner
Sanchez.
On second.
Kylie Sanchez coming up to bat. Runners are in first and second.
Ball one.
Expect Rubio to try to make them commit to something out there. One out.
As Sergio Garcia remains focused in the outfield. Absolutely.
I don't know. I thought I saw the Domino's truck show up behind him.
Ball two. You got Sam over on the first base side doing his job. And then you got Dave rolling around in the truck. It's all good.
And then over third base, you got one eye. Oh, Mike Wazowski. Our camera.
That's a ball.
Another ball.
So that's so three balls.
No strikes.
And one out.
Surely don't want to walk Kylie and leave Amira with bases loaded.
With bases loaded. Ball.
And there it is.
Bases loaded.
So bases loaded.
You got one out.
One out. Amira Rodriguez coming up to bat. The catcher is going to go up and talk to the pitcher. Trying to figure out, do we walk this girl?
Coach Martinez is going, you can't walk her.
Well, you got JoJo Montes coming
right.
Yeah,
you got JoJo. You got JoJo Montes coming up. No way.
Yeah.
You'd have to be nuts. I guess JoJo wants a, she wants a grand slam herself.
Yeah, why not?
Why not? All right, now, let's just handle the situation. You got one out. You got bases loaded.
Well, you know what? It, being that that last batter was walked, you know, let's see what the pitcher, we've got to make her pitch.
All right, let's see what the Unicorns can do here against the Lady Greyhounds. Bases loaded, one out. Top of the fifth inning. Strike one. Yeah, I mean, as the pitcher, you have no choice. You've got to go at it.
You're going to have to.
Otherwise, it's just not going to happen. Strike two. So gets ahead of the batter. So now Amira will have to react.
Yeah, and I think the outfielders are kind of worried about her reacting.
Yeah. And she doesn't need to hit a grand slam. She really doesn't.
Nope.
But any run is extra money, man. Ball. Ball one. Strike two. One out.
You know, pitcher's got to keep it within reach, because if that ball squirts out, Henry.
You got JoJo Montes on deck.
Yeah, got Rubio on third base over here, just itching to go.
She's just itching to go.
Yeah, she is.
There's a hit.
It's a huge hit, man.
It's going.
It's gone.
That's what I'm talking about.
What a bop.
Grand slam.
Another grand slam.
That's two, baby.
Huge.
Wow.
Huge.
Talk about clutch. I mean,
well, I put it this way.
There is,
that ball could have been out of any baseball field.
Yes, absolutely. The score. Now 5-0. So now as a coach, you must come in. You got to come in and you got to talk to your pitcher.
Yeah, you do.
Because she can get flustered.
Especially,
and that is the last thing you need.
Yeah, especially if you have JoJo Montes coming up to bat with one out on the board.
I don't know. I'm not getting anything from you, Fernando.
All right.
Hey, Dave, can you turn Fernando up a little bit on my side, please? Sorry about
testing
that, folks.
What? All right.
But
yeah, we're trying to get a little bit of noise going here. JoJo Montes up to bat here.
What about there?
Big grand
there you
slam.
Go. Now we're
big
good. Now we're good. Ya estoy viejo. Ya estoy viejo. Ya no oigo. All right, we're good. All right, ball one. No. We got one out. We got nothing. That's ball one. No strikes.
Yeah, the guy at the scoreboard, I think, is going to pass out.
I don't think he's had his Diet Coke up there.
I don't think so.
That's just what that is.
So 1-0 in the count.
Wow.
Jojo Montes, another big bomber.
Another big bomber. Ball. Two balls. And that's what I'm talking about, Fernando. As a coach, you got to go out there and you got to settle your pitcher down. She's flustered right now. Why? They just hit a grand slam off of her. She had, I mean, she was ahead in the count.
Yeah, she was. But she knew she had to pitch to her, you know. And you know, Amira knew that it was coming.
Here's
a strike. Here's a strike pitch coming to me. She went after it.
She went after it. No hesitation.
Oh, we've seen her hit some balls, Henry.
Perfect form. And that's with no wind right now. That's crazy.
That was all power.
That's high. That's ball three.
Ball three.
You still only have one out. Top of the fifth. Okay, that staves off that stake for a little bit. I'm into this ball game.
Not by much.
Not by much, though. Walks her. She really had no choice, Fernando.
No, not at all.
Because, I mean, if you pitch that young lady, that ball could have gone out. So now I've got a pinch runner now. What do we got in there, Fernando? Do you have that
one? I believe number one is Herrera. I think their last name is.
Okay, there you go.
I'm trying to think back from the previous game, but I don't have her on my list.
First base, number one, Sierra Herrera.
Yeah, it is Herrera.
All right, you're still at one out.
All right, Mia Gonzalez up to bat.
And we've seen Mia hit some really solid hits.
You know,
not a home run hitter.
You know, our middle again is our power group. Now we've got our speed group, and they like to hit the ball, you know, and get on base and use their speed.
Foul ball.
Little foul tip.
Fernando, she was going after it. She's
yeah,
trying
she
to hit the ball into the outfield.
Yeah, she can hit the ball.
Now the outfield is now in much farther in. But she hits one of those gaps, and watch out. Or she hits a line drive to third base. Watch out. Ball. One ball, one strike, one out. Runner on first, Fernando. Like I said, I don't know if the scoreboard guy's had his Diet Coke yet. He's falling behind.
He might need a little stronger, regular Coke.
Two balls. Ball. Three balls.
Three balls, no strike. Looking at the bullpen, nothing going on over there. Is she over there on the other side?
Yep. She tried to bunt that one. So it's three balls. It should be two strikes, but hey, it doesn't matter. The umpire knows. No, there is nobody. Yeah, there is one pitcher warming up over there.
Yeah, I see her on the other side over there. The coach was coming out.
Yeah, it should be two strikes. Three balls, two strikes.
Well, he's got 2-1.
Well, okay, man. Yeah, they're saying it's two balls, one strike.
2-2 now.
It should be 2-2. I mean, the first pitch was a foul ball. Yeah, there you go. 2-2. 2-2. Elias is going to challenge it anyway.
Of course.
And that's what you do. Why do you do that? Because you want to mess with the pitcher. You want to mess with the mentality of the pitcher. So now everybody's coming out. It gets everybody all flustered. Umpire says it's 2-2. There you go.
And that because the scorekeeper over here
hasn't had his Diet Coke, pal.
Hasn't had his Diet Coke.
I'm telling you. Está dormido.
Somebody buy him a Diet Coke.
Ray says,
little high pitch.
3-2.
3-2 this time.
Ray says that Amira must have had her Wheaties. I tell you what, man.
I'll tell you what.
She's going to come out on that box someday.
Oh, yeah.
She's going to be on the cover of that box. She's a heck of an athlete.
And she's only going to grow.
Yep. All right. Three balls, two strikes, one out. There's
Diego
a hit.
Gonzalez, nice little chopper to second
one.
Base.
Oh. Yeah.
Got away. Gonna advance to second base.
Okay. That still works. I mean, the shortstop did a great job. That was a routine play for the shortstop. But she didn't finish the play.
No, she didn't. Jenna Torres coming up to bat.
All right. Got a shout out from Mark Villanueva over in Katy, Texas, man. Life is good, Mark. He's one of our former football players. Strike. Hey, nothing but good thoughts to you, buddy. Okay? Hope all is well, man. And I'm glad you're enjoying the ball game. There's a hit, and it just went foul.
Over the first baseline.
That could have brought in another run. Could have.
Yeah, Amigo Gonzalez was already on third base. So meanwhile, Mia stays at second. Jenna Torres trying to get it going here.
That ball is low. So one ball, two strikes, two outs. And again, we know what the Lady Hate Greyhounds can do when they have two outs, Fernando. So it's all good.
You know, it almost seems like the game doesn't change for them.
No, it doesn't.
You know, they don't change
They just keep doing what they got to keep doing. There's a hit.
Oh, right to
That's going
to
be an easy out. Okay. So not before the Lady Greyhounds are able to put four runs on the board. That's going to bring us to the bottom of the fourth inning.
Yeah, with a big bomb from Rodriguez coming out.
Yeah, incredible grand slam there.
So now, bottom of the fifth, Lady Hounds 5, Unicorn 0.
There you go.
So now it comes down to pitching and defense.
Now, notice the scoreboard, Fernando. New Braunfels now has two errors.
He's got two errors.
So, again, who's going to make the least amount of errors during the ball game? Well, I think somebody woke the scoreboard guy up.
I think so.
He's playing some good music up there.
Emily Delgado not wasting any time. Took one pitch and they said, I'm ready.
Let's go.
Bring it on.
Five to zero in favor of the Lady Greyhounds here at the bottom of the fifth inning. The winner goes on to the Elite Eight in the state tournament.
What a feeling.
What a feeling is
what
right.
What a feeling. Been there, done that.
That's right.
We were 2 points away from a Final Four appearance at
That's
Austin,
right.
Texas.
Coach Martinez has been there before.
There you go.
All you got to do is look at the outfield. Oh, she took a swing at it. Wow. That ball was around eyeball height. But she was going to slap the ball, so that's what she was going to do. So you got one strike, no balls. Bottom of the fourth inning. Good slap there. Ball
That's
falls in
does.
For a single.
Yeah. She's had success with it, Henry.
Yep, absolutely. So you got a runner on first.
Yeah, leadoff runner on first.
Go for Lily Warren.
Hey, you just heard a fan saying one run at a time. That's right. You know, one out at a time, and that's right. That's what you do. That's what you focus. So now the girls are going to try and get the leadoff runner, get her out. There's a swing. That's foul. So that's strike number one. Yeah, J-Rod says, unleash the hounds. That's right, J-Rod. J-Rod's at home, man, on his big TV watching this ball game.
There you go.
That ball is high, 1-1. He's sending good vibes over here to Corpus Christi.
He sure is.
That's ball. Ball two, strike one. Oh, strike. Thank you for the nice comment there, Lily. Lily Zapata over in Arlington. She's watching the ball game. She's a former Greyhound herself. Thank you for the nice comment. Certainly appreciate it. Two and two. No outs. Man. Three and two. That was
three
tough.
Three and two.
Three and two. Three and two. Of course, Fernando and I, we're being umpires over here from the side.
Oh, yeah.
It's all good. Hey, at least we get a steak after we're done. It's all good. Oh, got her swinging. Yep. There's one out. Hey, I tell you what, big shout out to Frankie Flays because they always, always watch our live streams.
There you go.
You know, so thank you guys at Frankie Flays.
No kidding.
Hope you got a crowd there enjoying a nice ball game.
There you go. We've got to stop by one of these days, Henry.
Absolutely. Okay, so what are the odds that they're going to walk this young lady right here? There's one out. They have not allowed her to bat at all today.
The umpire is going to go have a conversation after talking to the Unicorns coach. See what this call is going to be. Coach Elias over here is like, what are they talking about?
Got her out.
Yeah, she was swinging in her.
Yep.
And the bat actually got way across over here. Past first.
You know, it's a difficult thing to be an umpire in baseball or softball.
Yeah, it is.
You know, I mean, it's tough enough in football. Yeah, they're going to walk her. Watch. There you go. Going to walk her. Not going to allow her to bat. And
uh-huh.
That, you know what that creates, Fernando? Look at that. That creates frustration on that young lady's part. It's all about attitude, pal. She wants to be given the opportunity to hit, and it's not happening.
First and second, and one out. The next batter, first baseman number 19, Grace Simons.
All right, you got one out. You got a runner on first.
Hey, coach. Coach.
It's 5-0. Ball one. No strikes. One out. Emily Delgado, the girl with all of the experience in the world, pitcher for the Greyhounds. That's low. Two balls. Two balls, no strikes. Of course, Emily is the niece of our good friend Rick Gonzalez.
There you go.
Who now lives in, he's been living in San Marcos the past 30-something years. So, you know, Rick, I know you're proud of your niece here, so. As we all are.
They wind up being, I want to say.
There's a big hit down the left side.
Foul ball.
So now it
wind up being second cousins or third cousins, somewhere in there. We're related somehow.
There you go.
Now, of course, Emily's mom, Lorraine, and I graduated together.
There you go. Now, what class are you from?
That was a 81.
81. Your class of 81.
Class of
along
81.
With, along with my compadre, Ron.
There you go.
And my comadre, Annalisa. There you go.
Both of them.
Big shout out to both. All right, two balls, one strike, one out. There's a good hit. Oh, that squirts through. Going home.
It's got a chance.
Yeah, she's safe. And she's safe. So just like that, the Unicorns are able to get on the board. So one run comes in. You got two balls, one strike, one out. It is now 5-1. That's what this game is supposed to be about, Fernando. You got two very even teams going at each other. I guess she's got the wrong bat.
Yeah, something didn't feel right there.
Let's see, Coach Martinez talking about something. And of course, all of this is simply to slow the game down, Fernando.
That's
the idea. It's all about psychological.
Oh, yeah.
At this point, it's a psychological game.
Trying to ice the batter.
That's it.
Calm the fans down.
That's it.
You name it.
All right, you got one out. You got runners on second and third.
All part of the game,
you know, is right.
You know, my mentor, Coach Capello, he used to talk about that mental game with the coaches.
Ball one.
Especially if the official happened to be passing by.
There you go.
You know, and talk about, it's just unbelievable.
You know, Coach Roberts, back in the 90s, he used to talk to the football players, don't ever let the little man get to you. And
there
that's
you
right.
Go. That's
don't,
right.
If you let it get in between those ears, watch out. Ba-ball. But you never forget that. Don't ever let the little man get to you.
No.
All right, scoreboard says two strikes, no balls. I thought it was 1-1. Yep, 1-1. 1-1, one out. Okay. Foul ball. One ball, two strikes, one out. So, Rachel, your niece is Jenna Torres. Way to go, Jenna. Thank you for tuning in, Rachel. Absolutely enjoy it. Ball, 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, one out. Takes a swat at it. There you go. And they're able to hold a runner.
Great job. That's a great defense,
hey,
Henry.
Talk about sending a shout out to Rachel, because she's Jenna is her niece. Jenna just made that play.
Oh,
that
yeah.
was great. She looked off the runner and then went to first. So now you got, just like that, the Greyhounds have two outs. Score remains 5-1. Thank you. Little slap.
Little foul tip.
Strike one. More importantly.
Feel a couple of the raindrops, Henry.
I know. I saw him on my phone. I'm like, uh-oh. You know what? There's no stopping these kids now.
No.
There's a slap. That's two strikes. No balls, two strikes, two outs. Top of the fifth. A lot of instructions going out there right now, Fernando.
Yeah. All sorts by both coaches. Huge pitch right here, Henry.
Fighting it off. Still no balls. You got two outs. Winner goes to the lead eight. Emily calling for a different softball. The batter knows, she's got to stave everything off because Emily has the ability to just blow right by her. So she's got to stay on top of the ball as best as she can. Runners on second and third, two outs, two strikes, no balls. Score remains 5-1 in favor of the Lady Greyhounds. There you go. That is what you do. That is why she is such a great pitcher.
There you go.
She will rise to the occasion.
Closed out that one inning right there. Of course, the Unicorns brought in one run, but still hold a 5-1 lead, Henry.
So, that is two innings to go.
San Benito 5, New Braunfels 1.
So let's see what the Lady Greyhounds can do. I tell you what, and our umpires coming right by us, these guys have done a great job. I don't care what anybody says. I mean, it's a tough job, but you know what? They step into the job and they do a great job. What? So Patty Maldonado just posted that she's at the Longhorn Steakhouse. She's got a ribeye steak with mashed potatoes. What? OMG.
Hey, Henry, stop licking the screen.
It's all good. Okay, so Amira Rodriguez's cousin, Ileana Gonzalez, just posted the home run.
There you go.
On Facebook, so that's pretty awesome. And thanks for tuning in.
Well, here's what we got coming up here, Henry. We got Leila Lopez coming up to bat. That's going to put the Hounds back on the top of the batting order with Bethany Aguilar on deck.
Folks, don't forget. Winner goes to the Elite Eight.
There you go.
Semifinals. That's a ball.
Off to the Greyhounds. Center for number 4, Leila Lopez.
Strike one. That was a nice off speed right there. 1-1. I don't know what's going on with the score. Maybe he's having dinner. I don't know. But it's 1-1 right now. One ball, one strike. There's a hit. She tripped over the bat. It's all good.
You know, it's not often that kind of a hit gets stopped at
right,
that point, Henry.
Right.
Usually when you get anything close to around second base, it's going to go right through. You know, that shortstop, it really gets a good jump at it. And she plays deep.
She
doesn't
does.
Play up very much.
All right, Bethany Aguilar up to bat now for the Lady Hounds. We're the top of the sixth. That ball is high. And then we come back to the top of the order, Fernando?
Yes, ma'am. That is Bethany Aguilar up there with Alicia Rubio on deck.
That's high. And again, the Lady Hounds don't think twice about, you know what, oh my gosh, we got two outs, what are we going to do? They just keep doing their job.
They just keep playing.
There's a strike, two balls, one strike. A little high, three balls, one
strike. Three balls, one strike.
And we also got to send a shout out to Isabel Gonzalez, who's out here. She's a PR.
Oh, no.
She's a director of PR. And you know what, man? Isabel, Notre Dame grad.
Yeah.
We're really proud of her.
Well, you know,
does a great job.
That job by itself is a.
There's a ball to center field. And there's your out. That's out number two.
You know, that's a thankless job, Henry.
Yes,
you know,
absolutely.
She's got to be able to cover all the positive and all the negative.
Exactly.
You know? And, you know, she's on the beck and call with the superintendent, and that's a tough, you know, I can't write to begin with, but the things that she puts out are just outstanding.
Absolutely. All right, two outs here at the top of the sixth inning.
Yeah, because I can send her something. Hey, look this over. And I thought it looked pretty good, and all sorts of red marks and all
yep,
over.
Yep, there. Yep, that's right. Strike one.
But then again, that's why we have her there.
That's right. She does a heck of a job. All right, no balls, one strike. Elisa Rubio.
Elisa Rubio.
There's a little slapper. Goes to the shortstop, and there's your third out. So that ends the top of the sixth inning, Fernando.
Yeah, so we leave Emily Delgado at bat coming up. So.
Exactly. All right, let me talk about my little story here. We used to go fishing. Fernando and I used to go fishing. And we got to this one place. We had been hunting redfish all morning. Finally found some redfish over on the west side of Rattlesnake Bay. I'm sorry, the west side of the Intercoastal. John anchors the boat, gets down. Like I said, he probably weighs about 140, 145. And Fernando and I, well, we're kind of hefty, you know. We were probably at that time certainly well over 250.
Oh, yeah.
But you know what? We're thinking we're fishermen. We both have waders on. John gets off the boat, walks over there to where the fish are at, and me, the big dummy that I am, decide, you know what? I'm going to get down with my fishing rod, and I'm going to go get those fish. I get down, and I sink into the mud. All the weight of my hip.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh. And then you can imagine one leg is up on the boat, one leg is in the mud, and I'm yelling at Fernando,
oh, yeah.
Help
Henry,
me.
You can picture this. Henry did one of those Jean-Claude Van Damme splits, and I just rolled over laughing.
And Fernando, I just like, he couldn't stop laughing. I'm like, dude, I need your help.
No. And John's over there just yelling at us
to be quiet,
you know, because we're scaring the fish. Oh, boy, that was just
finally, somehow, Fernando was able to pull me out of that muck.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, I didn't get off the boat.
After that, we ain't getting off no boat.
And I'm thinking, if Henry went down that deep,
I ain't
I'm going
out
way to China.
Those were the days, Fern. Those were the days.
Oh, boy.
All right, here we go. Bottom of the sixth inning. We got an inning and a half to go, Fernando. Let's see what Emily can bring here. She's brought the heat all night. There's a first hit, but that goes foul, so that's strike one. I tell you what, the story of the night has been Amira Rodriguez. She has hit two grand slams here today, which is crazy.
Wow.
But she's a heck of an athlete. There's a big hit, gonna go to right field, but that's out number one.
That's just good defense right there.
That's just good defense, that's right.
Got a good jump on it and.
Well, Alyssa got a great jump like you just said and was able to make the play. And Elias, Coach Martinez, man, he's got a young team out here, Fernando.
Oh, he
and
sure
they
does.
Are just doing incredible. I mean, they have risen to the occasion.
You know, and that goes back to our feeders, our boys club.
Yeah,
softball,
absolutely.
And everything, that's going on. Just amazing.
Okay, that's ball one. I don't know what that was, but it's all good. And stinking Ernie Leal sends me a picture of all the fish he caught today. What
there
the
you
heck?
Go. Look
three
at
reds
that.
And three reds and three trout.
Nice.
Well, good for you, Ernie. Enjoy those steaks, pal. Nothing like redfish on the shell.
Man, it's been a while, Henry.
There's a strike. 1-1. 1-1, one out. Bottom of the sixth.
I got a fishing story here for you in a little bit.
All right. Ball two. Two balls, one strike. Of course, the unicorns right now, they're just trying to slap the ball so they can get on base. That's the idea. Jenna's way up, the third baseman. That ball is low. So that's three balls, one strike, one out. Bottom of the sixth. Yep. Three balls, two
Goes
strikes, full count. One
two,
out.
One out.
As JoJo Montes get instructions from the coach. She's telling Emily what to do, and JoJo gets her instructions from the coaches over here by the dugout. Slapper to short. Well, they called that one safe.
They called it safe.
Okay, well, now the unicorns with a batter or a base, first base, got a runner on first.
What a throw from Amira over here.
I mean, that was solid.
It was humming.
It was humming as an under. I mean, you heard the pop.
Number two, Matt Gaspar.
So with one out, the unicorns managed to get a runner on first.
Ball one. As the lights come on here in the stadium, or they've been on, but now you can actually see the light. Emily's gonna regroup herself. It's getting closer, folks. Ball two.
Mm-hmm. Kind of low, but he's calling some strikes on that side.
Well, Gilbert Flores wants me to put Worcestershire sauce on my steak.
There you go.
He just sent me a picture. Okay.
2-0 in the count.
Ball.
High in that one, 3-0. Last thing you want to do is start walking some batters.
Yeah,
here.
Exactly.
Let your team but play some defense here.
Again, Emily with the experience, Fernando.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, oh, yes. I mean, she's throwing where she's being told to throw.
I can bet you a shiny penny this is coming right down the middle.
There it is.
That I tell you.
There it is.
Two balls, one strike. Just comes down to how bad do you want it? Ball. Now you got runners on first and second. You've got one out. Time.
Time.
Coach Martinez.
Right, Coach Martinez gonna
go out there and talk to his troops.
So my good buddy and I, Mark Becerra,
okay,
decided we're gonna go fishing early in the morning. We're gonna get out there. We want to be on the water before the sun comes out. So here it is, like 4 a.m. going out to Arroyo City, and we get out to Sanchez Bait Stand. We got a little ramp right there. So, you know, we're trying to be as quiet as possible. There's houses around there and all that. He backs up the boat and gets nothing. And I'm helping him out. So I decide to step out there under the near the trailer and you know, kind of unhitch it from there. And I hit that slimy stuff that's at the bottom right there.
Oh,
and
my
man,
gosh.
I go sliding. Feet first under the boat, splashing everywhere. There are birds yakking and dogs barking. Man, the whole neighborhood woke up.
Woke
and meanwhile,
up.
I spend the rest of the day all wet and green from that slime.
That's just
unbelievable.
Tough.
And then we didn't catch a thing.
Yeah, that, you know what, Fernando? That's why I just go to HEB and buy my fish
now.
Yeah,
just buy the fish there. It's a lot cheaper.
I don't even mess with it.
A lot cheaper.
All right, here we go. You got runners on first and second. You got one out. There's a little splash bunt. That's going to be out number two.
That holds the runners.
Now the Greyhounds have two outs.
Well, they're looking to try to get this one out because their best hitter is coming up on deck. So if they're needing out, this is the time.
Oh, it's a big hit to left field. Out number three. Just like that.
Like that. Gave
that
us two.
Ends the sixth inning.
Now here it is, the last inning. If they can hold on here, pick up a couple of runs, Lady Hounds can move on to the next level. Now, there's a chance for got a quote here from Joel Rodriguez. It says, one famous coach once said, champions are like biscuits. They rise to the occasion. There you go. That's coming from J-Rod out there. So here we go. Top of the seventh inning. Lady Hounds up 5-1 with their big hitters coming up to bat. We left off with Emily Delgado. So here's what we've got coming back. Emily Delgado will lead off, followed by Kylie Sanchez, Amira Rodriguez, Jojo Montes, and Mia Gonzalez. That's a lineup right there. This pitcher is going to have to face all of those right now. Here's an opportunity for the Lady Hounds to extend this lead.
Ball
So here we go, last inning. Could potential be the last inning. Emily Delgado up to bat. Going to make the pitcher pitch. Strike number one. I think Emily will hold on for another pitch. No balls, one strike. Takes a hit right over first base, and it's going to be good. She's going to take a double. Nope, she's going to hold up at first. So Emily taking a shot in an area where the ball has not been hit at all today and gets onto first base. So leadoff batter on first, bringing up Kylie Sanchez. Now Kylie can hit the ball. And again, this is our power hitting group right here in the middle of this lineup. Little bunt, trying to decide where to throw the ball. Catcher could not decide where to throw the ball. Now, you got two runners, runners on first and second, and guess who's up to bat? Number 14, the Bomber, Amira Rodriguez. What do you do here? Runners on first and second. Pitcher's gonna look at this. She's already has two hits on her. Amira sizing up the pitcher. Looking like she wants a good one. Took a strike. No balls, one strike, and took a hit. Goes right to the shortstop. Shortstop bobbles it, throws a lateral pitch, and everybody holds the base. This is one of those a few errors that shortstop has made. Threw it wide to the third base. Unfortunately, the ball bounced right back into the infield, so Emily could not get around to go to home plate. So a lot of action here. So just like that, Henry, we've got a... Just like that, we got bases loaded with no outs.
And who do we have at the plate?
Well, you know, Jojo Montes was the other Grand Slam earlier.
Yes,
you know,
exactly.
So we've got runners on base, no outs. It's been exciting. Everybody has been able to hit the ball right now. The pitcher's struggling right now. Coach went out to talk to the pitcher. We got a runner.
As J-Rod just said, champions are like biscuits. They rise to the occasion.
No kidding.
That's exactly better.
You call a ball?
What did he call a strike?
Called a strike.
Okay. I mean, that looked like a strike, so. This is big, Fernando. I got to stand up because this is big.
You're right. I think I'm going to stand up myself.
That's low.
A little bit low on that.
1-1. And you got no outs, pal.
Got no outs. Bases loaded. Coach Martinez is salivating over this one.
Exactly. He has to be. He wants those insurance runs.
He's going to give her the green light and hit it.
Strike.
Strike two.
One ball, two strikes. Got runners, bases loaded. Let's see. There's
another
hit.
Another one, hopper to third, and miss
Everlane. No outs.
Everybody advances, Henry.
No outs.
Meanwhile, Emily Delgado takes a run in.
And here's the other thing, Fernando. So that third baseman has made the same error. That's the second time she's
That's
made
right.
that error. Okay? So that's just vision. That's all that is.
That's it. You know, and talking about earlier, the shortstop made an error earlier, which he had not made any mistakes. He's been playing flawlessly.
Oh, there
so
you
now,
go.
Lady Hounds take the 6-1 lead at the top of the seventh inning.
That's three errors. Three errors against them. You still have no outs. Mia Gonzalez is a formidable bat.
Oh yeah.
That's high.
Now, Coach Martinez is gonna have him hit.
Now the other thing is your third baseman is completely down on herself. And that's tough. Mentally, I mean, what do? You keep playing the game. That's a little bunt, and that goes foul.
Just foul.
So is that 1-1?
Yep. It looked like one and one.
1-1. 1-1.
And we're not talking basketball.
And you know what Coach Martinez is doing right now? He's going to get every run he possibly can.
Oh, he definitely
one
is.
At a time.
With no outs, Henry? My God.
That's what he just showed right now. He's just trying to get every runner to advance. That's a good strike.
Oh, yeah. She took a good swing at it.
That's a great pitch. Once again, these are just kids, man, and they're doing a great job. Jenna Torres on deck right now. These kids have just, I mean, what can I say? That's low. 2-2. Mia Gonzalez. That one's low.
Another
full
low
count, pal.
Oh boy.
Full count, and you got bases loaded. And you have no outs.
No high. Walker, Henry. Another run comes in.
Walks in a run
with no outs. Jenna Torres.
That's right.
Up. All right. The score right now is 7-1 at the top of the seventh inning.
Well, I'm glad that Jaime Garza is at home enjoying our broadcast, man. Jaime, keep up the good work, pal.
There you go. Yep, Ms. Martinez, it is 7-1 right now. Bases loaded, no outs.
Strike one. There you go.
With Jenna Torres at bat. Waiting in the wings, Layla Lopez.
Girls are feeling pretty good right now, as everybody else in the stands,
well,
but it's not over.
Extend this cushion here. Another
There's
little bunt right there. They're going to try to take her out at first.
There's one.
No, at home plate, but one out.
One out.
They had to try.
Yeah,
Amiga
exactly.
Rodriguez was coming in with a full head of steam, Henry.
Yeah, if you wanted to have anybody just come full bore, it would be that young lady.
All right. Number four, Layla Lopez coming up the bat.
Still bases loaded. That's low. Ball one. That's a lot of stress on a kid, you know, especially a pitcher right now. You got bases loaded, you only have one out. You know, everything has to count. And that's a hit to the outfield. And Elias is sending his runner. And just like that, get another run in.
Another run in. 8-1. That was the idea, Henry.
That's the idea.
So now, number five, top of the order.
That's two outs, correct?
Bethany Aguilar, that's two outs.
Yeah, I'm looking at the scoreboard. And I should not be looking at the scoreboard. All right, two outs. Eight to one lead. Ball one.
Low on the outside.
And you have to be very careful because the floodgates can open as we're moving through these batters. It just takes one miss hit or one misstep by the defense. Ball two. Is that ball two or ball one?
Thought it was ball two, Henry.
So did I. There it is, ball two. Ball two, no strikes, two outs. Strike one. Two balls, one strike, two outs. Top of the seventh, where the Lady Greyhounds have put three runs on the score so far on the scoreboard. There's a hit in the gap. Oh, and it falls in.
Gonna call the runners in. Going around, rounding second. And if she hadn't, I don't know if she slipped.
She slipped. She slipped, Fernando.
She could have made it to third.
Wow.
Well, just
that, that was impressive, my man.
Well, I'll tell you what. That's the way to play it, Henry.
That's how you play it.
I want to say two runs came in.
I want to say two runs came in also.
We're still trying to get it on the board here.
But we know that the board has been running late. The scoreboard has it 8-1.
Should be 10.
It's 10-1.
So now the score is 10-1. Five
you got
runs
two
have
outs.
Come in. Two outs. And I believe it's Lisa Rubio coming up to bat with two outs.
Very dangerous.
Very dangerous because, you know, once you get past Elisa Rubio, we're back to the heavy hitters. Henry.
Exactly.
And they're the ones that started all this.
So Coach Martinez gave her the green light. The outfielder, it actually went off of her glove and
yeah,
wasn't able to handle the ball. So it was just deep enough. Wow.
What an inning.
What an inning. Five runs so far in this inning.
Well, you know, they woke up a sleeping giant hitter.
Exactly.
Two out, connect back. Right with number three, Alyssa Rubio.
Now, Alyssa can slap one right over the infield.
Absolutely. Strike one. You got two outs. Yeah, the runner slipped. When she was coming around, when she was coming around second. There's a slap in the gap.
Oh, right in the gap, Henry.
Runner coming home.
Another run comes in.
Insurance run, pal.
That's it.
And I'll tell you why. That gives who else but an opportunity to go to the plate.
There you go.
Emily Delgado.
So now the score, 11-1.
To one. I hope you guys at home are enjoying this ball game, because this is so exciting. It's great being a Greyhound right now. Absolutely.
First two outs in the batter. The pitcher number 20, Emily Delgado.
Strike one. Okay, I don't expect her to go down.
No, not at all.
Looking.
I'm looking at Serge. Is it Serge? You better be ready over there.
Baba. Oh,
and she took a swing, Henry.
Yeah, no. She's not holding back, pal.
No, she's not.
She's like, you know what? I got a runner on first. Let's see what I can get. You got a 10-run cushion right now. There's a hit.
Right over
right
second.
Right between second and short.
Kylie Sanchez coming up the bat.
Holy smokes.
Third hit of the ball game.
All right, top of the seventh inning. Six runs have come in. Lady Hounds with an 11-1 lead now.
11-1, and look who's on deck, Fernando.
Yeah, Kylie Sanchez, I tell you what, she's gonna get the green light as well.
She can hit the ball.
Yeah, she can.
Strike one. Yeah, the pitcher has to throw everything down the middle. I mean, everything has to be guaranteed. You got runners on first and second. You got two outs. The Lady Greyhounds are used to having two outs and still producing. That ball is high. That's 1-1. Oh, my gosh. I tell you what. That steak is tasting better by the second.
Yeah.
Strike two. One ball, two strikes, two outs. Runner on first and second. There's a hit to left field.
Just
foul. Holy smokes. Are you getting sprinkles out there or what?
I got one drop. Might be that seagull that was.
It could be, pal. That's why I'm still standing under the canopy now.
I came out over here, honey.
I am not taking any chances.
I'm trying to get closer to home plate.
There you go. That ball is high.
Two and two. There you go.
Runners on first and second. So you got two balls, two strikes, two outs, and two runners on base. We know she can swing the bat. Big gap between left field and center. There's a hit.
There it is.
Right, and there it is. Going
and
home.
He's gonna send her. Going home, man.
Yeah, they got her out. That's a great play from
I'll
center field. But not before the Lady Greyhounds are able to put six runs on the board in the seventh inning. That's
huge. Now it comes down to Emily Delgado and the defense.
Coach Martinez did not like the call from the umpire. This is serious business. It's not over.
No, because you got their best
well,
batter.
They're going to walk her, they're Fernando. Gonna? There's no out.
You think so?
Yeah, I think they're going to walk her. They're not going to. I mean, my thinking would be, you know what? You've walked her all night. Why allow them to get any type of momentum? But that's me. What do I know? I'm not a softball coach.
There you go. And me is like, go after her. The worst thing that could happen, you lose one run.
True. Let's see what the Lady Hounds are gonna do. Now, the last time that the Lady Hounds walked her, the Unicorns had a pretty good inning, and they were able to score four runs. No, I take that back. They got one run. How can I say four runs? They only have one run. And that was at the bottom of the fifth. Hey, shout out to Hector Castillo, the guy who built my home, man.
There you go.
There you go. I'm glad he's at home enjoying the ball game. Brings back good memories for him, I'm sure. Right, Hector? I'm sure it brings back good memories. It's all good.
All right, Henry. Here we go. This is it. Three outs.
This is for all the marbles. Punch a ticket to the Elite Eight. Ball one. They're going to pitch to her, Fernando. Like you said, you only have one run to lose. Worst case scenario.
Worst case scenario.
Or you can strike her out.
Or you can strike her out.
Or you can get her out off of a hit. There's a hit, going to second, out number one.
There you go. You just took out
their best hitter was just taken out at first base. Two outs away from making the Elite Eight are the San Benito Lady Greyhounds, folks. We certainly hope you guys are at home enjoying the ball game and are as excited as we are here at Cabinets Field.
No one is allowed on the playing field after the ball game.
Even the announcer is saying we don't want anybody on the field. Strike one. So you got strike one, you got one out. I don't know if they're having technical difficulties up there, but there is one out. That ball is low, so 1-1. 1-1-1. You can taste it.
Sure can.
There you go. One ball, one strike, one out. It's like tasting a good steak right now. Strike two. One ball. Two strikes. One out.
All right, Delgado ready. Just kind of taking her time out there, Henry.
That ball is high. So two balls, two strikes, one out. Nobody on base. Bottom of the seventh inning. I'm getting bit by mosquitoes now. Hot dog it. I swear, if it ain't one thing, it's another. But what do you do? Oh, nice. That was humming.
So two outs, nobody on base. This is it, Henry.
This is it. This is for all the marbles.
Three more strikes.
Wow. This is some serious stuff here.
Yeah. Fans are getting into it.
As they should.
They can feel it, Henry. They can feel it.
They can feel it. I'm telling you, you can taste it. That one's low and outside. Ball one. 11-1, the Lady Greyhounds. Bottom of the seventh. Strike one, 1-1.
1-1, Henry. 1-1.
I tell you what, Emily Delgado has shown her leadership throughout this game. As I just popped another mosquito.
Well, a message from J-Rod over there says, Henry, grin and bear it.
Grinning and bear it, that's right. That's what I'm doing.
Grin and bear it. Big foul tip on that one. It's two
one
strikes.
Ball, two strikes, two outs.
Yes, sir.
The fans in the stands.
Oh, yeah.
Is making it happen.
Going to bring the heat on this one, Henry?
The question is, she's just going to say, can you catch up to this ball?
There you go.
That's what it's going to come down to.
I'll tell you what, she took some rosin and getting her hands ready right there, Henry. You know what's coming next.
Wow, talk about leadership, Fernando. This little
taking
girl.
Her time. Just taking
great,
her time.
Great job all year long.
Taking in the moment, Henry.
That's it. There's a hit to the outfield. Girls are running, but that goes foul. I tell you what, Alyssa Rubio was on her horse trying to get to that ball, and she almost got there.
She almost got there.
I Let's see here. Rick Lugo.
You got it.
Trust me, Rick. I'm going to enjoy my steak. Trust me. One ball, two strikes, two outs. The moment, Fernando, you can just feel it.
Oh, yeah. I sat down just so I could jump out of my seat. I might fall over. But
there's five, a big hit to
five,
center field.
Five, center field.
Who's could got it? Be? Oh,
got
number
it.
Three.
Got that.
Ticket to the Elite Eight, baby.
There you go. Just like that, Lady Hounds advance and stay alive.
Well, Dave wanted us to let you guys know at home that you guys need to stay tuned to Greyhound Nation.
There you go.
For any update following the next round.
There you go. I'll tell you what a series here. Lady Hounds on top, taking 2-1, and then taking command of this game, scoring 11-1. So, for KBG Sports, this is Henry and Fernando signing off.